নমস্কার প্রিয় দর্শক, সীমার পরিধি ভাঙি এই অনুষ্ঠানটিলৈ আজি পুনৰবাৰ আপোনালোকক স্বাগতম জানাইছো। আমি আগেই কৈ আহিছো যে কৃষ্ণকান্ত সন্দিকৈ ৰাজ্যিক মুক্ত বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ে শিক্ষাৰ লগতে সমাজৰ উন্নয়নৰ ক্ষেত্ৰত বিভিন্ন ধৰণৰে বৰঙণি আগবঢ়াই আহিছে। আজি আপোনালোকলৈ আগবঢ়াব খুজিছো এই বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ৰ আন এটি বিষয়। এই বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ে শিক্ষার্থীসকলৰ সুবিধাৰ বাবে বিভিন্ন বিষয়ৰ পাঠ্যক্ৰমৰ পৰামৰ্শ আগবঢ়াই আহিছে। আজি আমি আপোনালোকক দেখুৱাবলৈ লৈছো এনে কিছুমান বিষয়ৰ পাঠ্যক্ৰমৰ পৰামৰ্শৰ কাৰ্যসূচী, যাৰ দ্বাৰা ৰাজ্যৰ বিভিন্ন প্ৰান্তত এই বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ৰ অধীনত অধ্যয়ন কৰি থকা ছাত্ৰ-ছাত্ৰীসকল উপকৃত হ'ব পাৰিব। গতিকে আজি ফাংচন অফ মেনেজমেণ্টৰ ওপৰত পাঠদান কৰিব কৃষ্ণকান্ত সন্দিকৈ ৰাজ্যিক মুক্ত বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ৰ ডিপাৰ্টমেণ্ট অফ কমাৰ্চৰ সহকাৰী অধ্যাপক ডক্টৰ দেৱজিত গোস্বামীয়ে। আহক আজিৰ এই পাঠদান কাৰ্যসূচীলৈ।
We are going to discuss a very important aspect of management, that is functions of management. This aspect is included in your first chapter of management process and organizational behavior. So let us discuss this particular aspect, functions. Functions of management means what a particular manager performs in a particular organization. See, when we generally use the term management, it generally gives an idea that we are discussing about a particular business organization. But management is not like that. So when we use the term management, it may be for any organization, not only for profit-making organization, but the same principles can be applied to a not-profit-making organization, means to an NGO, hospital, educational institution, any organization, we can apply the management principles, and the manager there is can apply the managerial functions. Same in the sense that in a particular business organization, a manager performs his managerial functions. So far as management functions are concerned, therefore, there is no variation in the nature of management. All functions can be applied to any organization. So let us start with the first function of management, number one, that is planning. Let us start with the function of planning. So in management, we have planning, then number two we'll discuss, discussion, number three staffing, and then directing, and lastly, the controlling function of management. All these functions we'll discuss now. So let us start with the first one, that is planning. So in a very simple way, we can define the plan, or the planning means it bridges the gap between the present and the future. Where we are today and where we want to go in the future is linked by this. Planning means we have to plan the future course of action to achieve the objectives that we have set for the organization. So in the planning aspect or the planning function, we have to set the objectives. Break down the objectives into goals, and for achieving this, we have to formulate the strategies. These are all part of planning, means a manager have to set the objectives for the organization, and accordingly, he have to set the strategies for the achievement of these objectives. So, in this aspect, strategies may be different, means we have different options to achieve a particular set of objectives. Now the manager's job is to select the most efficient strategy to achieve the set objectives in terms of time, maybe in terms of cost, maybe in terms of organizational resources available, etc. So these are the various factors that a manager considers while formulating a plan. So planning also involves decision making. So in our daily life, we often make some plans. For example, suppose in the evening, we have a plan to go for a movie. So that is a very simple kind of plan. But in case of a very large organization, consider an MNC, where the planning purpose take a very high degree of time of a particular executive, particular manager in framing the objectives, framing the goals and strategies for his organization. So this function is very important from managerial aspect. So it is the first function, and on the efficiency of plan, on the effectiveness of plan, the whole organizational success depends to a great extent. Because in planning, we have to consider both external as well as internal factors, and accordingly, we have to move with the plan, with the strategies that we have set. So now, let us discuss the second function of management. Number two, it's organizing. So we use the term organization, organizing in this way. So if we use the term organization, it refers to an entity. Organizing, it's a process, it's a continuous process, involves various steps. Then again, it's a group of people. Means if there is an organization, there are some people working in the organization, and with these people, the whole organization will run. And thus, structure. Structure means there is an organizational structure. That organizational structure is for the flow of authority and responsibility. So, organizing is a process of dividing the whole organization into some sections or some divisions or departments or branches. Means the total organization is divided into some small sections so that the work can be divided. Means the application of principle of division of labor. So the whole organization has been divided into some sections. Somewhere that may be known as departments, somewhere that may be known as divisions, etc., etc. So by dividing the whole organization, we are dividing the whole line of activity, whole the objectives, and assigning each part of the work to a particular department or particular sections. So this particular section will have people. This particular department will have some other people. So each person will be responsible for his particular work, and if that particular person perform his work carefully, then all other works can be united together, and the objectives that we have set in the planning process can be achieved by the organization. So organizing simply is the division of the whole organization, dividing the organization into small groups, and accordingly the work is assigned to each individual and the departments, and like that the whole organization work are done and the objectives are going to be achieved by that particular organization. So let's start the third function of management. So we have discussed planning as a function of management. Next, we have discussed organization, organizing, and the third one is staffing. Staffing. It is concerned with the human resource that an organization has. So definitely it includes certain aspects like HR plan. So at the beginning we have discussed planning as a managerial function. And again here we are getting the term plan, planning, that is HR plan, human resource plan. So we have to calculate the inventory. Inventory means the stock items that we have or the stock item that we are going to place order. In case of HR planning, HR inventory means the people we have, the skill we have and what type of skill we may need in the coming future. So this has to be calculated and we have to make a plan. So it is the planning for the human resource, the resource that we are getting for the organization. Then some other aspects it covers are job analysis. Then recruitment. Selection, etc. All these aspects will be covered by the staffing aspect. So this is particularly important because if we have a plan, if we have an organization, means all the physical resources are available, the organization has been properly divided, but if there is no human being to run the organization, how the organization will achieve these objectives? Considering this thing, the staffing is very important because in staffing function, the manager have to deal with his superiors, the manager have to deal with his subordinates, and the dealing must be in a proper form so that he can achieve the set objectives. So he have to motivate his subordinates, he have to provide a good leadership, and by providing good leadership, he will be able to mold the human resources of the organization, and accordingly, the main team of the management, that is getting things done by others, can be performed by the manager. So next we'll discuss number 4 function, directing. Here a manager have to direct the human resource, direct his subordinates. He have to provide the guidance, how to do the work, how to achieve the objectives of the organization. So in planning, he set the objectives. In organizing, he organized the whole organization by dividing it into departments, into sections. Staffing, he recruited people. And in directing function, he have to provide the guidance. Because without guidance, how his subordinates will move for the achievement of the organizational objective. So this particular function of management is concerned with the guidance, means he have to provide the leadership. He have to motivate, and accordingly he have to, in the light of organizational objectives, he have to guide all the human resources that he have recruited for the organization for the achievement of the organizational objectives. So this is important because it is also concerned with directing of human resources as well as directing of the physical resources of the organization. So these are the 4 that we have discussed, and we have another important aspect, functions, that is number 5, function of management, that is controlling. So we have discussed some other functions like planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and it's time to discuss about controlling. So controlling is an important function of management, and if we have a plan, we must have control. So if we are planning for a particular target, we are formulating a particular strategy to achieve a particular objective, we must have some control. Control means how we'll detect any deviations from the planning. In planning, we set the objectives and we formulate the strategies. But whether these strategies are performing well to achieve these objectives at the set time, this have to be calculated, this have to be compared. So that is connected with controlling. Means in the mid of performing our task, we have to see whether we are performing well, whether we are performing in terms of the achievements to be achieved, whether we are formulating these strategies properly. So these are the certain aspects that will be covered in this important function of management, that is controlling. So controlling is concerned with four important aspects. So I can rub this now. Controlling. The related aspects that we have talked about, number one, establishment of standards. Standard means the objective that we have set in the planning stage. Number one, means we have set the objectives, we have established the standards, how we will perform, what we are going to achieve. Then number two, it's measurement. Measurement of performance. Means we are continually measuring our performance. We are evaluating our performance. We are acting on the basis of these standards, and at this moment we are seeing whether we are performing according to the said standards or not. So we are measuring our performance on the basis of the said standards. And number three, now you compare. Number three, compare between the set standards and the what we have performed. So it is a comparison. So controlling is comparing. So if the results of the comparison shows that there are some deviations from the set standards, set objectives, then we have to take some corrective actions. So corrective actions.
So within this particular functions, that is controlling, the completion is pertaining to the set standards of the organization, sir?
Yeah. Okay. Set standards means the objectives.
Objectives.
The targets we have given to the subordinates.
Subordinates.
The targets we have given to our production department.
Yeah. Reviewing.
Reviewing. Yeah. We are reviewing.
The assessment.
Yeah. Assessment. If it is according to our set standards, then the organization can run smoothly, and it's going on to achieve the
target.
If there are some deviations, then the job of manager is to take the corrective action to correct the deviation. Yes, so that we can achieve the long-term objectives, the organizational strategies. So this is all about controlling aspect of management. So it is the important function, because if we have a plan, if we have the organization structure, we have the organization, if we have the people, if we have properly directed them, then why will we not able to achieve the objectives? So that is important, and we have to continuously monitor our resources, our
functions,
our performance. So this is connected with the controlling function of management. So these are the main functions of management that we have discussed. So let us quickly summarize the things. Today our topic of discussion was the functions of management, where we have discussed planning, number one. Number two, organizing. Number three, staffing, concerned with human resource. Number four, direction. And number five, that we have just discussed, is controlling. So these are the five functions of management. So today our topic of discussion was functions of management. We are closing it today, and we'll discuss some other topics in some other day.
Sure.
Okay, thank you very much.